Hi everyone, my name is Leah Kapke and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. In each one of these episodes, we go over another 3D modeling tool for Cinema 4D. And in today's episode, we are going over smooth shift. So let's jump into Cinema 4D and show how it works. So here we are inside of Cinema 4D. We'll make sure that we have lines on so that we can see what's happening, and that's under the display menu. Now that we've done that, we're going to drop a cube primitive into our scene as so, and we'll increase the segments to 2 in the X, Y, and Z. And now with that done, we can go ahead and hit the Make Editable button or use the C hotkey so that we can begin editing this. So something to know is that smooth shift only works with polygon mode. It only works with surfaces. So you'd have to select surfaces first in order to use it. And just so that you know where to find it, you can find it under the mesh menu under add. And you'll see here we have smooth shift. And next to that, you can see the hotkey is MY. And that's how we're really going to access this tool during this tutorial, is using the hotkey because it's quicker and it'll help you remember it. So we'll go ahead and do that. But first, what we need to do is we need to select these polygons. So let's go into polygon mode and select some of these over here. I want to select this one on the top. I'll select this one here on the bottom. And I'll select these on the side just so that we make an interesting abstract shape here using the tool. And now that we have those all selected, we're going to use the hotkey MY. And after I click M, you can see under Y is our tool, smooth shift, so we'll use that. And this is a pretty fun tool. So the first setting you'll see here is offset. And something to keep in mind is that this tool is very, very similar to the extrude tool, except that it adds a bevel between your extrudes. And you'll see a little bit of what I mean by that as we start using it. And if you're interested in learning more about the extrude tool and how it works, I'll leave a link to it in the description below. But just to focus on this tool initially right now, we have our offset. You can adjust it with the slider here, or you can click and drag your mouse and you'll see that the offset is adjusting. Now you may be looking at this and saying, you know, Leah, you said that we'd see bevels between these extrudes, and I don't see any bevels. So the reason why we don't see bevels right now is we have the maximum angle too high. So the maximum angle, what it's doing is it's calculating the angle between the extruded surfaces. So you'll notice these extruded surfaces are 90 degrees to each other. So it won't show that bevel if we have a maximum angle that is higher than 90 degrees. Now, if we decrease our maximum angle below 90 degrees, we could even make this 89 degrees. Since all of those angles were 90 degrees, if we make this 89 degrees, just 1 degree less than 90 degrees, you'll see that we have that bevel that I was talking about before. So that's what your maximum angle does, and you know what your offset does. Now, similar to the extrude tool, they both have that option called offset variation, and it basically means the same thing for both. So if we increase our offset variation, and I think you'll actually be able to see it easier, maybe from the top, either in here and here, maybe I'll change this mode so you can see it better. So we have this shape here, and if I start increasing the offset variation all the way up, you'll notice this side is being extruded less than this side. So what it's doing is it is randomly varying how much each section is being offset. It's easiest to see it from the top view, I find, but that's what's happening. You can also see it here. This side isn't being extruded as much as this side. So that's what's happening when you use that. I'm going to remove the offset variation. You'll also see another option called subdivision. So what I'll do is I'll increase the subdivisions. And right now you can see our subdivisions are zero and create n-gons is grayed out. So I just want you to keep in mind that this is grayed out right now. But once we increase our subdivisions, all of a sudden you can see create n-gons is no longer grayed out. And you can also see that we are subdividing the sides of our extrusions in here. So all the sides of our extrusions now are being subdivided. And this actually looks pretty cool. I think you could 3D model some really cool robots using this if that's something you enjoy doing. Now, if I turn on create n-gons, that's going to allow this to create n-gons with our subdivisions. So you see how this looks now? I'll click this button. Now it looks like our subdivisions are gone, but they aren't gone. And I'll show you how they aren't gone. So if we go in here, we can see that there are still individual edges. So this is still being subdivided. Just this polygon here, instead of having four edges, it's still subdivided and now it's an n-gon and it has all of these edges here. So that's what is happening there. And something else I'd like to show you. I'll click here and I'll click here. Maybe we'll use this tool again for this area. So I'll use MY. And I don't want to create any more n-gons. So I'll go ahead and extrude this area here a little bit. And this is actually something you need to watch out for. So you can see that we have overlapping surfaces here, and this is not good. So that's something you need to be careful of while using this tool. You don't want to have these overlapping surfaces here. It will cause errors. So that's just good to keep in mind. So I'm actually going to hit undo. We aren't going to extrude that. It's easier when they're angled like this so that you're extruding outwards instead of having something this shape that'll extrude outwards and intersect. If you extrude this section outwards, it won't intersect. So just keep that in mind while you're using this tool. So MY, we'll extrude this on out. And we have preserved groups turned on. And if we turn this off, now that we have preserved groups turned off, you'll notice that maximum angle is grayed out. So it's no longer using the maximum angle with preserved groups off. And that's basically how the preserved groups works. It's going to bevel that area regardless of the maximum angle. So I just turned up the maximum angle really high, and because we have preserved groups off, it's just disregarding that and it's still beveling these. But if I were to turn this on again with that maximum angle really high, you can see there is no beveling happening. Unless if I bring this maximum angle down. So I know that bit's a little bit confusing for a lot of people. So I hope that helps you understand how that works. This kind of looks like it could be a spaceship or something. It's more abstract. I was just trying to show how the tool works. But I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and had a great time learning how Smooth Shift works. And if you'd like to learn more 3D modeling tools, please hit like and subscribe so that you'll be notified when the next episode comes out. And thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time on Ambient 3D Animations.